Αγαπητοί μου φίλοι, κυρίες και κύριοι, καλησπέρα σας. Καλώς ήρθατε στο απόψινό μας πρόγραμμα «Η Ομογένεια κοντά σας», MGTV USA με τον Μιχάλη Γιακουμέρο.
MGTV. Η Ομογένεια κοντά σας.
Η Ομογένεια της Νέας Υόρκης γιόρτασε με υπερηφάνεια την επέτειο των 200 χρόνων της Επανάστασης με την καθιερωμένη έπαρση της σημαίας στο Bowling Green του Μαχάτη.
Σήμερα οι κάμερες του MGTV θα σας φέρουν κοντά στο event που έγινε στο Bowling Green του Μαχάταν στη Νέα Υόρκη, ύψωση της σημαίας που γίνεται κάθε χρόνο από την Ομοσπονδία Μίζωνος Νέας Υόρκης. Μίλησα για τα 200 χρόνια απελευθέρωσης της Ελλάδος από τους Τούρκους.
My name is Lou Katsos. I'm the governor of District 6 here in New York of AHEPA. It's wonderful to be here on the 200th anniversary of the Hellenic Revolution as we raise the Hellenic flag here at Bowling Green. This area is very historical. To my right, there was a very large Hellenic community in the old period. And here on Broadway was the first Hellenic American Independence Day Parade in 1893 on April the 6th. There was about 300 Hellenes. They walked to the City Hall down the block and they raised a flag at City Hall. It was at the time Governor Tom Gilroy, and they raised the Hellenic flag there. And it was by Vlasis, who was the president of the Brotherhood of Athena, which was the first fraternity in New York City, and they were also the people who raised the money to build the first Greek Orthodox church in New York, which was the Holy Trinity. Thank you for all for being here. I love it. Congratulations, Zito Yalas.
Right here around the corner we have Morris Street. I hope the Archbishop knows this, that the famous St. Nicholas Church did not begin on Cedar Street. It began in 1916 right here on Morris Street when some Greek immigrants in their boarding house began celebrating and created St. Nicholas Greek Orthodox Church. To do something more for the Greek community, and I think it's worthwhile, and especially if the Archbishop will support it, I believe Morris Street should be named honorarily Greek Independence Way. And with your support, Archbishop, let's make it happen. Thank you all very much.
Good afternoon. Well, we're here down at Battery Park for today's celebration of the raising of the flag to celebrate 200 years of the Greek Independence Day.
For a fantastic event celebrating the 200-year anniversary of the Hellenic Revolution.
My name is Paul Makropoulos. I'm here to celebrate the 200th anniversary of the Greek Independence Day.
My name is Fernando Mateo, and I am honored and humbled to be here celebrating the 200th anniversary of Greece's independence. May God bless Greece, and may God bless everyone that's celebrating with us today.
Γεια σας, ονομάζομαι Κωνσταντίνος Πρέντζας. Βρισκόμαστε εδώ στο Bowling Green στη Νέα Υόρκη, που σήμερα θα γίνει η ύψωση της ελληνικής σημαίας άλλη μια φορά.
Hello everyone, welcome to the Bowling Green. My name is Anastasi Stampolis. I'm the president of the Constantine Cassis chapter, number 170, out in Hempstead, Long Island, New York. I'm here today on behalf of the District 6, Director of Operations. I'm also here today as a proud Hellene.
As we get ready to celebrate 200 years of independence on this dark and gloomy day, in this dark and gloomy time of the world, as our young lady said, nothing can darken the light that shines within us, our spirits and our souls, the joy that we feel for the freedom that we have been blessed with, freedom of faith, freedom of democracy, and of choice. Let us celebrate the lives of those people that sacrificed everything to win that over for us and to spread that to the world. And let us try to understand that although we're not being asked to sacrifice our lives as they did of theirs, that we have a responsibility to make sure that we preserve it, the values, the faith, the culture for future generations to come. The world is unfortunately changing, and sometimes I don't think it's in our favor, But we do have that obligation to support other people, other countries who have the same dream that we had during those 400 years of persecution and being captive and not being able to celebrate our faith and our culture.
Σεβασμιότατε, κύριε Γενική Πρόξενε της Κύπρου, κύριε Πρόξενε της Ελλάδος, νομίζω ότι ακούσαμε σήμερα πολλά στοιχεία από την ιστορία, very important elements of history, very important pieces of Greek dances, traditional and more modern. But since we are in a place heavy loaded with memories, allow me, please, in the presence of His Eminence, to stand silently for a moment of reflection, a moment of respect, calling, join me, please, for a moment of silence, for one minute, please, for the victims of the pandemic who lost their lives in this very city and in the world, for the thousands of families who grieve their losses here in this very city and in the world and our back home, Greece, and for all those who are working tirelessly in trying to save our lives, to keep us healthy, our doctors, our healthcare workers, nurses. A minute of silence, please. Two 200 years ago, we were searching our path to freedom. Nowadays, we contribute as a country to solutions leading to security and prosperity.
Today, 200 years later, unity among Hellenes, both at home and abroad here in the diaspora, is as relevant for the cause as it was then. I am also very happy to see that the 200 years of Greek independence coincide with a period of excellent relations between the United States and Greece and the United States and Cyprus, probably the best they have been during the last 50 years. So I encourage our diaspora to be united and to focus on the cause. And finally, Chronia Polla. Thank you.
Your Eminence, may God bless us to stay on the right path. I wish our country many returns of this joyous day. Χρόνια πολλά, ζήτω η Ελλάδα, ζήτω η Κύπρος. Thank you very much.
Η Επανάσταση δεν συνέβη πριν από 200 χρόνια μόνο. Η Επανάσταση συνεχίζεται και θα συνεχίζεται όπου υπάρχουν Έλληνες. Χρόνια πολλά σε όλους μας. Να ζήσει ο Ελληνισμός. Ζήτω ο Ελληνισμός και η Ελλάδα όπου και αν βρίσκεται.
It's not only a Hellenic event, because don't forget, the Hellenic independence triggered a lot of things also in America. America gave to Hellas with many things that we're not going to talk about right now, but Hellas gave also to America. The people who left Hellas, the people who were here with the Greek committees, were the founders of the American abolitionist movement, and this is very important to note. Thank you.
Zito Yalas.
Zito!
Zito Ahepa.
Zito!
Ευχαριστούμε που μας παρακολουθήσατε. Το MGTV USA θα συνεχίσει να σας μεταδίδει τα δρεόμενα της ομογένειας. Αντίο σας.
MGTV USA. Οι δραστηριότητες της ελληνοαμερικανικής κοινότητας με βίντεο και πλήρες ρεπορτάζ. Επισκεφτείτε την ιστοσελίδα μας mgtvusa.com. Καλύπτουμε καθημερινά τα γεγονότα στην Ομογένεια.